Coming into the Belgian Grand Prix, Lewis Hamilton announced that he would be retiring from the sport at the end of the season and wants to go out with his 8th world title. Hello and welcome to my F123 Lamborghini My Team Career Mode, here today for part of 72 for the Belgian Grand Prix. We're here in Spa for the final round before the summer break. This is the grid though for the second sprint race of the season. So we're on pole alongside Lando Norris in his Ferrari. Then it's the other Ferrari, Charles Leclerc and George Russell. Then it's Verstappen and our teammate Carlos Sainz, Gasly and Teo Pacher, Joe and Bottas, Hamilton and Ocon, Piastri and Liam Lawson, Lance Stroll, Yuki Tsunoda, Dennis Hauger and Enzo Fittipaldi, Alex Albon and Kevin Magnussen. And on the final row of the grid is Logan Sargeant and Nick DeVries. So we're here on the grid then ahead of the second sprint race of the season, coming off the back of Austria a couple of rounds ago. We're going to be starting on the softs, doing the easiest strategy. The tyres last in all 8 laps and it gives us some good data for the race tomorrow, where we want to convert this sprint pole into pole for the race itself. So here we go then, can we keep the Ferraris behind as the fiberglass go out? We're racing for the sprint, but we've got a bad start. We've been jumped by Lando Norris and the other Ferrari. This Ferrari 1-2 as we go down into the first corner. We tried to go back down the inside of Leclerc and it's pinched on the inside. So we had a shocking exit coming off of La Source. They had Albert in the background, so we're going to go side by side with the Red Bull. But he had to back out of that. But we've had a shocking start. It's a Ferrari 1-2. We're down from first to third. Now can Leclerc have a go at his teammate Lando Norris? Can now get his first win with Ferrari in the sprint race. He just needs to keep those behind. Can he do it? As we're getting closer and closer to Charles Leclerc, we're looking to get back to the front. We've got a good exit coming off from the source. We're getting closer. We have the overtake button. We're going to go to the inside. Yes, we are going to do it. Keep it pinned around the outside of the Rouge. We're side by side. Leclerc though now has the better straight line speed. But we're going to get the DRS to push our way past. Just, we haven't actually got the DRS yet. That was straight line speed lap 2. But we're back up into P2. What a battle with Charles Leclerc braving it out around the outside of the Rouge. And we've left Leclerc in the mirrors and have got onto the back of Lando. We're getting closer and closer to Lando Norris. We've got good straight line speed in the car. This time we'll have the others, but he's fucking the double. Go to the inside, go round the outside. And Lando has to sell the PT, but we've run wide. We're offline. And Lando's just understeered into the side of us. Lando's got no front wing. And in the matter of corners, Lando's gone from the lead to having no front wing, but he is still P2. But now it's a nice little train behind him. Max Verstappen has got himself ahead of Charles Leclerc. It's now round the outside. This is the replay. So we just ran wide, we just understeered, and then I don't really know what Lando's doing now. I don't really know what I'm meant to do. He's just blatantly on the racing line, not really looking, and just taking the racing line and driven into the side of us. As we go around the outside of him there, run wide, have a little moment after we correct the oversteer, and then end of range. It wasn't really our fault, that bit of a racing incident. But what this has allowed, this has allowed us to pull away, as no one could find a way past Lando. So we had a lovely trolley train behind him as he boxes now to get a new front wing, and he's got a long Sunday ahead. It was looking good for him coming off the early couple of laps, leading into turn one, taking the lead off of us. And then I don't know, you can make your own mind up with that, but we were just pulling away. Max was slowly catching us, but he didn't catch us quick enough, and we ran the final corner to win. the Belgium Sprint. So that's your sprint race then, a very kind of eventful at the start and then fell flat. We were just keeping the gap down to Max. He was slowly catching us but wasn't enough for him in the end. So we are going to be on the front row on pole alongside Verstappen. Claire, we started the sprint race P3 and it's going to start the race P3. Sainz all the way down in P9 and our championship rival Lewis Hamilton nowhere to be seen, down in P10 just behind Carlos Sainz. You can see it's Magnussen and the two Haases starting stone dead last for the Grand Prix. Lando Norris getting himself up into P19, two less cars to overtake to get him back to the front for the race. We're on the grid though now for the Grand Prix and we know the softs can do 8 laps, so we can maybe go a little bit quick further with them. We're then going to go on to the mediums to get us to the end of the Grand Prix, and hopefully in 22 laps time we would have won the Belgium Grand Prix, but there's no guarantees. That Red Bull was very quick in the middle sector in the sprint race, that's where we were losing a lot of time. But then anyway, here we go, the five red lights are on, they're out and we're racing, and unlike the sprints we've got a much better start. We go straight over to cover off Max Verstappen. He's now head down towards our ridge. Verstappen's on the back of us and he's getting closer and closer. Leclerc's had a horrible start, he's lost out to Joe, then McLaren has to go sweeping through our ridge, and now this is Verstappen getting closer and closer. He's going to go to the inside where he's sitting duck as we head down the street. Here comes Max Verstappen. We try and hold it around the outside. He breaks very early and he has to leave it a four now. As now we go into the long right-hander. We've clipped the curb. We've gone a bit deep. We've gone very deep. In fact, we've had a massive oversteer moment and Max has gone, thank you very much. But we keep it pinned round the outside, had the extra traction. Verstappen has to settle for P2 as Leclerc's going back at the McLaren there as we run wide, and Max is just way through, holds it around the outside, and we, after defending him for most of the opening lap, he gets the job done on us. And now we have to rethink about overtaking him. It's gonna be We need to get it done in the first or the third sector because the Red Bull is so strong in the middle sector. It's now though lap 2, we're going to send it very late. We get a good exit coming out of the source. We're getting closer and closer to the Red Bull. We're too far back to have a go through our ridge, unlike we did to Leclerc in the sprint. But now we're so close, we're going to have to straight line speed to go to the outside, the inside. We've got a roll on the grass and we've got the straight line speed to go back down the inside of Verstappen and retake the lead of the Grand Prix. But Max weren't going away. Here he comes, he's on the back of us now, going through Blanchard. He's on the outside, he's getting, but he's had to back out of it, he's too far back to do anything. And now he's had to wait to the straight. 3 tenths per second that we can't do that. He's getting closer and closer to the back of us. They're close behind the Joe and the McLaren and not going away as well. Look at the straight line speed of that Red Bull with the DRS. And he retakes the lead off the Grand Prix lap 6 now. And we need to stay close. The Red Bull, I keep mentioning it, is so quick in this middle sector. As we go deep into the corner, Max has had a wobble and that's allowed us to go round the outside, gives us the inside line for no name. And I think Joe has driven into the side of Max there as Max was pushed a little bit wide by us. I think Joe may have front wing damage, because he did kind of, he went for it down the inside of Max very late. Max was turning back onto the track and he did pit Joe. You can see him at the bottom of the timing tower. Verstappen coming back at us down the inside, he goes, we hold it around the outside. This has turned into a great battle. We've had great battles with Max in the past and then it was just we couldn't break the DRS, but eventually lap 9 we did finally break the DRS, got it over just over a second, as we are going to box now at the end of lap 9 to make our one and only stop of the day, if everything goes to plan. Then Verstappen going longer, so can we use the undercut to pull away from the Red Bull? We're now into the pits with our marks beautifully then, purple time it. And we can get it racing again. As we come out of the pits, we've found a lovely gap to come out in. Nothing in front of us, nothing behind us. At the end of lap 10, no, this is Verstappen coming into the pits. Leclerc also coming longer, but I think the other Red Bull's in as well. Now, right at the front of the pit is the Red Bull garage. I think it's just slightly been held up by the Alpine now. In the background, science is boxing. But where are we relative to Verstappen? We're going down into turn one. Where is Verstappen? He's just there. But Max, the overcut hasn't worked, and I think we've actually gained a lot of time on him. The gap now, yeah, look, nearly two seconds. Lando Norris going longer in this race after his shocker in the sprint. We need to get this overtake done very quickly. We're all over the back of Lando, and we're going to do what we did to Max. We're going to go round the outside. Lando sees it coming, but we're going to send it late down the inside. Catch him napping. So by the end of lap 11, Max has caught Lando now. We were starting to pull away. Max is going to go to the outside of Lando Norris. Rouge. I think there's slightly contact there. I think Max was actually trying to do the up and under, but Lando just put it a little bit harder, but it hasn't stopped Max going round the outside and getting him before we even get to Rouge. But Lando's going to have the straight line speed and the slipstream now to try and re-overtake the Red Bull. And he's going to re-overtake the Red Bull. DRS is breaking very early there. I think Lando realises that this isn't really his fight. So he's backed out of it. And then all the way up to lap 17, we were just after our epic battle in the first half of the race, we were just keeping Max outside of the DRS. We were gaining in the first and third sector, but the middle sector, we just lost everything we gained in the first sector. That Red Bull was so quick. Lap 19, Logan Sargeant's car has given up and he is retiring at the first corner at La Source. His day is done. Lap 21 though, Max finally caught the back of us. From his perspective, not good from us. He's going to have a go going onto the final lap of the race. We're looking to make it another win in Spa. We've been soaking up the pressure of Verstappen. Down into turn one though, we've locked up. We're off the track. We've finished it on the sausage curb, and Max Verstappen on the final lap takes the lead of the Belgian Grand Prix. We may have just bottled it. The Red Bull so quick in the final, in the middle sector. We need to get the job done. We're getting closer and closer. We're going to have the DRS and the straight line speed. We're going to send it late. It's the only thing we can do. Round the outside, we've understeered off the track. We're bouncing over the grass. Max Verstappen is in the lead. He's pulling away. And on the very final lap of the Grand Prix, we may have just bottled it, but we have bottled it. We just need to try now stick with the Red Bull through this middle sector. But Max all the time is pulling away. It's going to be hard to stick with him because of the dirty air. It's now through the middle sector. We go through the chicane. That gap going up 0.7 seconds. It's the gap now 0.8. We're going to have to go all in at the bus stop chicane if we can even stay close enough. The gap is 8. It's now 0.9 seconds. It's now over a second. Max Verstappen is going to win the Belgian Grand Prix after putting pressure on pressure Oh, let's put it too far back to send it into the final corner. We thought about it. Max Verstappen is going to win the Belgian Grand Prix. We're going to have to settle for P2. And it's an absolute bottle job.
As they climb out of the car, the Red Bull team are ready and waiting to celebrate a thoroughly deserved win. What do you think it was, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition today?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs, and that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximise the strategy, and to stay out of trouble.
The drivers are en route to the podium as we speak. What a fantastic win for the Red Bull team. They've performed exceptionally today, keeping us firmly on the edge of our seats throughout the entirety of the race. Congratulations to everyone at the team.
As a driver once said, I am stupid. That is the definition of a bottle job. 21 times we went around that corner, 21 times we didn't do that. Final lap though, no, make the mistake, gift the win to Verstappen. He would have only realistically had one go down into the chicane through a roof, just keeping him at jamming distance outside of the DRS, and then the Max Verstappen effect, who cracks under the pressure. And we can't afford mistakes like that in this very close title fight with Lewis Hamilton. That is a lot of points dropped this weekend. I know we've still got some from the sprint, but are still 7 points we've lost at one corner. Fair play to Max, he was there when we made the mistake and has won the race. Hamilton finishing down in 8th, Carlos Sainz P7, and down at the back, Logan Sargeant, the one and only retirement of the race right towards the end. Lap 19 for him, he fell. Nyck de Vries, who was the final finisher of the day then. So in terms of the Drivers' World Championships then, Lewis Hamilton has a 25 point lead over us, and that should realistically be 18, but we can't change that now. That win for Verstappen now puts him P3, 47 points off Lewis Hamilton. McLaren kind of been running out of steam the last couple of races. Piastri right in the fight in the early rounds and has started to tail off a little bit. Down at the back though, there are 4 drivers still yet to score, including both the Haas drivers, Magnussen being stone dead last of the drivers in the World Championship. In terms of the constructors then, Mercedes now have a 60 point lead over us in P2. Red Bull are P3, they are 97 points back, 37 points back from us, so over a race, over a 1-2 from us. Then it's McLaren, Ferrari, Alpine, Aston Martin, AlphaTauri. Haven't really scored since the win in the opening race of the season. Then it's Haas, Alfa Romeo and Williams still yet to get off the mark. So that's been your Belgian Grand Prix and your sprint race as well. The sprint went as planned. The race for 21 laps was going as planned and we bottled it on the very last lap. Go to Holland next and I'll see you then. Goodbye.